medical costs for insurance. I was diagnosed with cancer in February, and I have glioblastoma, which is malignant brain cancer. My medical expenses are high, and recently we had open enrollment with the school board system where employees are allowed opportunities to change their insurance, add or, you know, make changes. Basically, I was told that I cannot make any changes at this time until I report to work again while I'm on medical sabbatical leave. The reason given to me, well, one of the things I would like to have opened is what's called a flexible spending account, where money is taken from your paycheck pre-taxes to pay for things like co-payments and prescriptions. I could really use that help right now, but it's policy of the school board that while you're on medical leave, you cannot make these changes. I was unable to find that policy anywhere on the parish website or in the employee handbook. When I asked about it further, I was told that it really was a best practice. So I said, what does that mean, best practice? A best practice means that it's been in effect for several years now and no one objected to it. So even though there's no written policy, it is their official policy. And I'm simply saying that for the amount of money that the school board might be left on the hook from, unpaid monies left in that flexible spending account, it pales in comparison to $80 million in tax exemptions. Basically, the scenario given to me was that what if an employer were to open an account like that and put a lot of money in it and then suddenly resign? Or I guess in my case, maybe not resign, but just pass away, then the school board would be left having to pay the taxes on that money that was taken out of my paycheck. And so if the policy is designed to save the school board money, it would be my hope that the school board would have the same zeal in reviewing applications for industrial tax exemptions that they have for employees who are ill. Thank you for your time.
Mr. Simmel, thank you